this becomes h omega, which is 1, and as omega tends to infinity, this becomes 0, this also becomes 0, this also becomes 0, this also becomes 0. That means all these zeros point, they merge together, and as omega tends to infinity, this blows up. So that means this becomes a impulse function, impulse function, and this is of course st. In that case, this becomes an impulse function, and you know the impulse function, the Fourier transform of impulse function is 1. So this way an impulse function can also be defined. We will be doing some problem on continuous time Fourier transform tomorrow again, and I will advise the students to work out some problem on this topic, because this is very important both in signal processing and in the communication area also. So we will be doing tomorrow mainly problems, so please try to do some problems from the book, so that you can enjoy this discussion. Thank you.